as an individual. Everyone wants to know when a work of art is there in front of you. You want to know what it is. Or as a art connoisseur or a viewer, I want to know about what is there in the painting. That what is the content of the painting, or any, for that matter, for anything else, anything. The content is the most important aspect. Unless you understand the content, you don't understand your work of art. So if it is connected with our culture, with our own mythology, it is very easy for us to understand the content and see what is there. That is how we basically connect ourselves with the paintings like Radha and Krishna, or the Buddha mythologies in the Ajanta paintings, Sistine Chapel. Or for that matter, anywhere in the world, when we know the stories, then we connect with the painting. And that connection makes us like understand the painting. That understanding means basically the content. So we look for content. So when we don't understand content, suppose if it is something like Greek mythology, or something it is like the Nordic mythology, which we are not aware, Norse mythology for that matter, which we are not aware, then it is difficult for us to relate. There we don't understand the word. That becomes an abstract thing for us. So which we understand becomes concrete, or we know about it. Which we don't understand, that becomes abstract thing. An artist, for that matter, how he looks at a work? He is generally not bothered about the content part. Content maybe he is aware, may not be aware of. It doesn't matter for him. For example, if you see a photographer, photographer doesn't see what is there in the photograph. Instead, he sees how the photograph has been taken. Similarly, an artist, a practitioner, he looks for how it is done. Okay. The how factor is the second factor, which is more, it connects an artist or the practitioner to the art. So how is that is a technique. Form. Okay. So he is more bothered about a form, how he is taken. Suppose if you are a photographer, you will be concerned about what light it is, what is the aperture, and what else. There are so many other aspects there in the camera, and how you know the camera. Does the photographer knows how to take a photograph more matters than what he has taken. Similarly, an artist also will take care of the formal aspects, the line, color, the light and shadow used. So the form is the second important thing, unless you understand the form. And you also need to judge the form from time to time, how it has evolved. Okay, the Renaissance artists, what they created may not be suitable for the 20th century artists. What is there in the Western art for formal aspect of Western art may not be suitable for the Indian paintings, because the two both are evolved in a different level. So understanding this, we, an artist or anybody, need to, understand art. The third most important aspect is why it is done. The idea behind that. Unless there is an idea, art cannot be understood. So what idea that particular work of art or a photograph want to reflect. So idea is why the artist has made this, why the photographer has done this, what is the conceptual aspect of that behind this particular work of art. Then we would know much more about, we'll be able to know much more about this particular work of art. Then, along with that, to understand, to evaluate a work of art is, we also need to know the time in which the work of art is done or work of art is created, the space in which, the geographical space in which the work of art is created. Also, context in which the work of art is created. So, this time, space and context on the one side, other side, content, form and idea. These are the most important aspects to understand a work of art and evaluate a work of art. Unless you understand this, know this, you may not actually or really follow. Thank you.